right, let's create some cute robots dancing in the snow with Midjourney. Midjourney has a very comprehensive syntax of how you can write prompts and how you cannot write prompts. And there's an amazing community out there of people who have learned this for half a year already. But this video is not about the Midjourney syntax. It's about how to get a lot of different styles really, really quick using ChatGPT and the AIPRM, ChatGPT prompt extension. What we see here is Midjourney, which has this interface, just a chat bot that you talk to. Okay. So we'll use this in a moment. And what we see here is ChatGPT with the AIPRM chat prompts. And these prompt templates here were submitted by the community already. And it's unbelievable how fast, how many great quality prompt templates get submitted. And we will only look at one, this four Midjourney prompts in different artist styles. Because if you have not started art, then you may not know about artist styles to look for, how to name a material. And these are all things that are very niche to artists. But if you're not an artist, but still want a great result from Midjourney, this is for you. So I just type in cute robot dancing in the snow, just the keywords, and it generates four different prompts that you can use in Midjourney. So we're done. We have four different styles here. And I've never heard of I cannot even pronounce the name of the artist, but I'm sure it's a fantastic artist. Otherwise, it wouldn't be suggested. And what we do here is we go to Discord, just say, imagine, and then paste that prompt. That's it. And of course, I've been trying this before, and there's a variety of different styles that are already used and just upscaled. So the Tim Burton style may be familiar. This one here, maybe not. And all I can say is I absolutely love the variety of different outputs here because I need to find a style. I cannot describe it. There's a whole community of Midjourney prompt scientists that know exactly what to write. But not only do I not know that, I don't have time to learn all that. Maybe you have, but I am building software. I'm building an AI prompt community called AIPRM, and I'm looking at the different prompt templates that create this output here. And that's just fantastic. So here we go. What do you say about that? I think it's a unique mix of styles described here, and all I want to do here now is to make them big, upscale, and use them. Of course, you could still run through different variations here with a V, and then they might draw the images a little bit different with the mouth different. And of course, this demo here should just show you how fast and easy, how great the results are. You can always improve all that. And on the other hand, I just want to download this and use it. ChatGPT understood what I wanted because it had a prompt template that we gave it. And when you try this again, shall we try it again? Oh, no, I want to try another one of these prompts. We got four. This one GPT run just gave us four prompts to try. It was an endless supply of ideas that you could try, that you could look at. This one here. Imagine, and this one here, and I'm going to try the fourth one as well. Joshua Davis Lieberman. I don't know these guys, but we'll look at their style. No, I have no problem saying that I don't know all these artists because I'm a software engineer. I'm a marketer. I'm not an art expert. I'm sorry. I don't plan to become one. I just want awesome images from artificial intelligence, which is, to be precise, a large language model specialized in text to image generation, which is Midjourney. Or Stable Diffusion, or DALL-E, and many more to come. And okay, and here's the kicker. We just try the same prompt again that we just tried, and we will get different four prompts. Four new prompts that we have not gotten before. Illustration by Sarah Andreas. Okay, let's look at that one. We're generating these prompts here faster than my Midjourney Pro account can render them. And of course, you're not obliged to use them all, but my idea here is I want to see the different styles and then pick the best one. Steve Jobs had himself made 10 different varieties of the iPhone or something like that, and then just trashed 9 of them. That's one way to approach design. And I like it because it's so absolutely effortless. Look at that. Amazing. Why would I spend hours to tweak a prompt if I can get that far already and then use one of these results to continue on that? How would that work? Oh, of course, you copy a link to this image and then you can paste it in here. You can give Midjourney its own result and then say, okay, that was a silver white, but in red, no, red body, blue head. I'm not even sure if that works, but you can add all kinds of interesting prompts like the stylized prompt, get a lot of different variations in the chaos parameter, and you can add, let's say we give it a seed, but that's an integer number up to 4 billion. So it's basically just, it feeds the random generator. Oh, look at that. They're just popping out here in my feed. And the biggest job now is just looking through them and deciding for one. Look at all of that work. Okay. That's just fantastic, isn't it? Yeah, that's how ideation, how generation of ideas works with Midjourney and a simple idea of a cute robot dancing in the snow. What do you say? Does this excite you? Does this scare you? Do you think the knowledge about the exact syntax of what to write here will be important in 6 months from now? Of course. In fact, there's always room for specialists, but this new approach opens up a whole new way of getting amazing generative art out of ideas. And this is, look at that. The robot was completely reimagined with the chaos parameters. And of course, this is where the magic is. If you learn syntax, like for Midjourney, you can get even more out of the models. So it's not a replacement. It's giving you a kickstart. How's that for a kickstart? Okay, we actually spend a lot of time in Discord and not a lot of time here in chat, but that's the beauty of it. And I've not scrolled through all of these and I've not had the time to look at all of these, but I encourage you to do. All you have to do is go to www.aiprm.com and install that browser extension. It's a browser extension for Chrome or Edge in this case, and it also works in mobile browsers like the Kiwi browser on Android. Okay, enjoy.